Hi everyone, this is Vin from the Azure SQL team. Today, we will show you how you can create a database populated with sample or backup data, as well as getting started with database design. How do I create an Azure SQL database populated with sample data? Let me show you how you can do that. First of all, we are going to go into the Microsoft Azure portal, and on the bottom left-hand corner where we can select an Azure product to be created, I'm going to choose SQL database. Let's call this database sample database. And under select source, I'm going to choose sample. Once I have a selected sample, we can see that a default sample selection has been made for us. I'm going to leave the pricing tier as standard as 0, but you can change this pricing tier to any pricing tier you want. With this, I'm also going to create a new server. Let's call our server sample server. I'm also going to have to enter a server admin login. With location, I'm going to choose West US. Okay. I'm going to leave the resource group and subscription as is, but you can change these as needed. The database with sample data will be created in a few short minutes. What if I want to create a new database from an automated backup? Microsoft will automatically backup your basic, standard, or premium databases on a daily basis. Let's go back to where we can create a new Azure SQL database. And we're going to call this database database from backup. This time, under select source, we're going to choose backup. Once I have selected backup, a list of backups will be provided for me to choose from. This may take a few moments to load. I'm going to select my sample is fun database. And once I've selected that, all the other fields are already pre-populated. I'm going to leave these fields as is and just press create. How can I get started with my database? With any database, you can now open the database context in Visual Studio from the Azure portal. Let me show you how. Let's start by opening the sample database we created earlier. SQL databases. And here's my sample database. Here on the database blade, you can see that we're given the option to open in Visual Studio. To be able to open in Visual Studio, you will have to configure your firewall as well as get Visual Studio 2013 with Update 4. If you haven't already, there are instructions on this blade. Let's click on Open in Visual Studio. I'm actually opening Visual Studio 2013 Community Edition, which was announced free last week. Once we've opened Visual Studio, I'll be prompted to enter my credentials to access my database. Let's enter that in. On the left hand side, you can see that Visual Studio is connected to my database. Let's expand the list of tables. Let's add a column to our customer table. I want to right click on my customer table and view this in Designer. I'm going to add a hobby column to my customer table. When I press update, this will commit the schema change to the Azure SQL database. With SQL tools in Visual Studio, you can also write SQL queries as well as start up a project with the schema of this database and work with it offline, then publish it later. That's all I have to show for now. Thanks for watching.